Hey, I touched that problem in one of my blog posts about 2 months ago. The question is whether we keep everything, all the source code in one large repository, or we break it down into smaller parts. And there are so many articles about that, even conference speeches, where people are suggesting that it's better to keep everything in one large repository, no matter how big it is. And for many reasons. For example, they say that it's easier for delivery, for packaging the whole thing and delivering to production. Also, they're saying that it's better for making changes because everything stays in one large namespace, in one large directory and subdirectories where you can, you change files here and there and they interconnect to each other. You don't have any external dependencies. Everything is connected inside, and when you want to release and make changes and release, then you just make changes, package the whole thing together and deploy. Continuous integration is easier. That's what they're saying, because everything is in one place. Again, no external dependencies. It's just easier. And they keep it all together. Even, I found many articles for that by big guys like Google, including Facebook and others, which are saying that we decided to move to that direction. We decided to keep everything in one place because it's better for this and that. I totally disagree with that. I think that approach is similar to saying that it's better to have one large class with many methods inside because it's easier for maintainability, it's easier for delivery, it's easier for making changes because, look, it's a large class, all the methods stay together, we don't need to go from class to class, from file to file, we just make changes here and that's it. That's ridiculous, I think. That's just, well, I understand the reasoning behind that saying, but this is just wrong because it's a path to completely unmaintainable code. Because if you keep all the pieces together, it may look more maintainable for you while you're working with that. But in the future, the more changes you make, the more people get into that project, the more developers are interested in actually making modifications to that code, the more difficult it will be for them. In Xerocracy, in our team, and I think you should do the same, we practice the completely opposite approach. We think that repositories have to be not only as small as possible, but focused on one single technology. So if it's a Java language, then it's repository for a Java language. If, for example, in your project you have something in Java, something in JavaScript, something in Ruby, and then something in XML, for example, then it's better to split that into four different pieces and configure four different algorithms, four different procedures for delivering that stuff, for testing that stuff, for continuously integration that. So for each technology, we absolutely need to have one single repository. So there are no mixes of technologies inside repository. So we never have like one GitHub repo for the Java inside and also the JavaScript. And it also helps us for management because we have sort of flat teams where everybody can get the next task no matter what are the qualifications of that person. So if the programmer is a programmer for Xerocracy, for Xerocrat, for our chatbot, it doesn't matter what that person is professional in. If the developer is in the project, then randomly that developer will get the tasks from Xerocrat. So that's why we need, single technology in one, in each repository. And I can see why those big companies like Google and Facebook going for the monolithic repository. Because I'm not going to say stupid, but I think their programmers are just lazy to configure everything correctly. Because it is more difficult. It is more complex. It will take way more time to break down large pieces into small ones and then configure individual routines for packaging, delivering, testing, and everything. Of course, it's easier to put everything in one place and just, ask one group of people or one guy to configure everything, make sure everything, all the tests pass, and make sure the continuous integration is done right, and that's it. And then it's call it a day. In my blog post, you check it out, I demonstrated an example of how I took a large piece of code, a large repository, and then extracted a smaller piece out of it and made even a standalone open source component, which that bigger repository is using now as an external dependency. And you can see how much time it took for me. There's the question of just maybe, I don't know, like 50 lines of code, but I've spent like maybe a day or so, maybe a bit less, for doing that. But what I achieved thanks to that, what benefits I got, is incomparable to the potential mass and maintainability issues which I would have if I would keep that smaller piece inside a larger repository. So my recommendation is no monolithic repos. The smaller you can, the better. Stay tuned.